Do you remember your first jump when you were 7 years old? How you got up there?
You know, I remember just, it was in 2002 when the Olympics were in my backyard in Park City, and I had gone off jumps on the side of, you know, alpine runs all my life, so it was nothing bigger than that, but I remember that winter more specifically than anything, just being on my alpine skis and being on the hills and just loving the whole environment and wanting to do as much jumping as I possibly could.
What was it about this kind of big jumping, though, that you liked as opposed to alpine skiing?
I think what I loved about ski jumping was how it's so peaceful, it's so rhythmic, it's very unique in the way that it's not popular in the United States. And something drew me to that, and also just the technical component of, yeah, we do the same thing over and over again, but there's never really a perfect ski jump, so there was this challenge. And I never want to flip, I never want to spin. Something about being in a very controlled environment on a ski jump, I don't think people realize that everything that we do is very controlled. All our equipment, all the, you know, the wind meters, the speed, everything is very safe. And people hate when I say that because they roll their eyes when they right. say when I say that ski jumping
safe?
Is safe.
Right.
But it's such a traditional sport that we have nailed everything down, so the risk of error is very minimal compared to these other flipping and spinning sports.
Right.
But yeah, I don't know, all those components kind of drew me to the beauty of ski jumping.
And when did you know you were really good at it? What was the moment where you said, this is something I could maybe do in the Olympics someday?
I was probably around the age of 10 when you really start to fly. You know, you start on those small jumps and you're just kind of up and down, but when you get on a hill a little bit smaller than this, you really get that flight time, and I love that. I live for that still to this day. And at the age of 10, when I started to feel that, I was like, okay, this is really fun. And obviously when I was 10, it wasn't in the Olympics for women. And I just stuck with it because I had the passion for it and I wanted to keep flying. Not necessarily because I wanted to be an Olympian or on the world stage, but because I wanted long flights.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.